Hello, this is Steve Nelson with the National Weather Service in Peachtree City, here to discuss the chance for severe weather tonight and the outlook for the next 7 days. Here's a look at what was happening earlier today with the weather. I'm using a new National Weather Service site called the Enhanced Data Display, whose web address is preview.weather.gov/EDD, that's D as in David. I'm overlaying the current radar and National Weather Service watches and warnings on this display. Notice at this time that this was captured, the storms are just firing over the Arklatex area. I've also overlaid the active mesoscale discussions, which are created by the forecasters at the Storm Prediction Center in Norman, Oklahoma. These discussions address areas of developing hazardous weather, often before a watch is issued. You can read the text on the screen there to see the one that was issued earlier this afternoon. The web address at the bottom of this slide is a link to this particular display that I created. If you'd like to see what I use, check it out. There are a lot of options on the site, so take some time and go through them all. This may be helpful to you while you're tracking the storms later tonight. As we mentioned, there is a threat of strong to severe storms tonight, and let's look at that in a little more detail. They're going to sweep through the area basically after midnight tonight, and we could see some damaging winds maybe to 70 miles per hour with these storms. Shown by the Storm Prediction Center graphic in the lower left, especially, is highlighting an enhanced threat of damaging winds for the system. Not so much the hail or even a lot of lightning. It's mainly the wind threat. We also can't rule out an isolated tornado. That it really shouldn't last long. These kind of conditions we're expecting are not favorable for large or significant tornadoes at all. North and west of I-85 is the most likely area to see severe storms. And also know that there will be a greater vulnerability to downed trees and power lines with this particular system, mainly because of the winter weather we had. If you had freezing rain or heavy snow, those trees and tree limbs are going to be a little bit weaker and may not be able to withstand the wind, so be aware of that and keep that in mind. Areas that saw mainly sleet, you're probably better off as far as the trees, but this is still a strong storm system and you may have some impacts as well. Just maybe a little less vulnerable than those areas that saw the freezing rain and heavy snow. Timing information is kind of provided there at the lower right of the screen, but we're going to go into some more detail on that next. All right, here's the position of the squall line you can see on the screen. This is a reflectivity from a computer model. We're going to show you hour by hour this particular computer model, which happens to be one of our best performing high resolution models. It's a 4 kilometer wharf EMS. You don't have to worry about what that means, but basically it's a model that we actually run here in our office and we can customize for the region. Keep in mind that this is only one model, and our meteorologists really look at a lot of different models to create the actual forecast, but it's easiest to display just this one model with detail. So let's look at it. At midnight, this wharf is showing a squall line basically over northern Alabama, but it's moving quickly to the east. Here's 1 a.m., 2 a.m., 3 a.m., notice how fast it's moving. At 4 a.m., the model shows the storms entering the north and west suburbs of Atlanta. And then the storms are along I-85 at 5 a.m. At 6 a.m., we're really noticing a weakening trend here with the reflectivity forecast. This matches our experience and observation that squall lines often weaken close to sunrise. 7 a.m., 8 a.m., the weakening continues. 9 a.m., and finally at 10 a.m., what's left of the storms are moving out of our forecast area and into southeast Georgia. As I said, this is just one computer model forecast, but our experience with him has been more positive than not. After the storm system moves out, the weather really isn't forecast to be too bad with fair weather and near seasonal temperatures. The next chance of rain will be on Sunday, especially over middle Georgia, where we could see up to a half inch of rain. There is some agreement between our two primary long-term computer models on this, one in the upper left part of the screen and one in the lower left, so our confidence is pretty high on this. No instability is indicated so far, and so we're not expecting any severe weather with the system at this time. Behind that storm system, there's another one approaching on Tuesday that's fairly weak, but as you can see, there's not as good agreement between our two primary models as in the last slide, so our confidence on the timing and likelihood is lower. We'll keep an eye on this, but again, at this time, this storm system, like the one on Sunday, is not showing any instability, so we're not expecting any severe weather. Here's the 7-day forecast for Atlanta, just as an example. You can see the generally mild conditions and near seasonable temperatures, along with the small chances of rain on Sunday and again on Tuesday. The best part about it there in the upper right, you can see this is a no-snow forecast. We're happy about that and hope you are too. As a reminder, if you want a specific or detailed forecast for your location, you can do that anywhere. All you need to do is go to weather.gov/Atlanta, as shown on the screen. Enter your zip code or city and state in the box in the upper left that I've kind of indicated there, and the small icon on the right. In that corner of our website, you can get a detailed forecast for any location. And once you get that page, I would recommend bookmarking that, especially if you're going to be reusing the forecast, and just check that periodically, as we are really, our meteorologists are updating that all the time. In summary, severe storms are likely tonight north and west of I-85, entering the state after midnight, then quickly move into the Atlanta area around 4 to 5 in the morning. Storms are going to weaken after 5 a.m. with heavy showers and some heavy rain, maybe some thunderstorms as well, and gusty winds moving through the area south and east of 85 between 5 and 10 in the morning. After that, pretty much seasonable temperatures near normal values, with another chance of rain on Sunday and Tuesday. Not expecting any severe weather at this time with those. And the good news, like I said in the upper right, no snow or ice is in this forecast for the next 7 days. Well, that's about it. I hope everyone enjoyed this, and have a great week. We'll see you next time.